Welcome to the Dig Mandarin YouTube channel. I'm your host, Lorelei, and today we're going to talk about a topic that may seem a little awkward. While it may seem awkward at first, after a little explanation, it'll make a lot more sense. Have you ever listened to a native Mandarin speaker and picked up on a few words that seem similar to other words in the English language? In this episode of Confusing Chinese, we're focused on one word that may at first not seem so politically correct. Whether you're in China, listening to your Mandarin teacher, or at a Chinese restaurant, the word 那个 may have been used once or twice. But worry not. You're not listening in on people throwing around a racial slur. The phrase 那个 has a variety of pronunciations and ways to use it. Let's take this time to focus a bit more on the pronunciation. The most common way of pronouncing 那个, especially for students of Chinese, is with the pinyin 那 and 个. Depending on how you pronounce these two characters, it may not seem very close to the N-word, but this isn't the only pronunciation of the word. 那个 is another very common pronunciation. Depending on the accent and the speed that this word is said, it can be edging on being indistinguishable from the N-word. Now, why do people even use this word? Most native Chinese speakers don't even realize the amount that they use this word. To be fair, do you know how many times a day you use words like, well? Let's look at the first usage of 那个, 第一个. 那个 is best described as a tick or filler word. It can fill in space. In English, we use well, like, as a way to interject or to express thoughtful hesitation, doubt, or perplexity. 那个 is used in the same sense. It's basically a filler word for Chinese. It is something Mandarin learners can use as well. It can make your Chinese sound a lot more authentic if you find yourself using English filler words in the middle of a Chinese sentence. Let's look at an example. 我昨天吃了那个那个. As a learner of Chinese, you may have said 我昨天吃了 that. You may not hear yourself doing it, but it is something to consider. 那个 can be used perfectly in Chinese class. We need a bit more time to think of the answer as well. It's authentic and helpful. And like are somewhat involuntary when we speak Chinese or English. We may filter it out when we're speaking and listening. However, as learners, we need to be more sensitive to it. Now for the second usage of 那个, 第二个. The second way to use 那个 and 那个 is as a demonstrative pronoun. What constitutes as a demonstrative pronoun, you may ask? It can express something that you can't say directly, something you're too shy to say, or something you don't want others to know. This can range from something innocent to not so innocent. For example, 亲爱的,今天我们那个吧. You definitely need context to understand what 那个 means in this case. So be careful how, when, and where you say it. In this case, it could mean, let's go do that thing tonight, something you've been meaning to do. Or it can mean something a little more intimate. Context is everything. The third usage of 那个, 第三个. 那个 and 那个 can be used to replace 请问 in an informal situation. At a shop you frequent, you may need to ask the clerk where the closest subway stop is. If he's a bit busy, just say, 那个最近的地铁站在哪里? In an informal situation, this is a great way to get someone's attention. Just be sure you're not using it in a formal situation. The fourth and last usage of 那个, 最后. 那个 can simply mean that. It's used before a noun, always. Since 个 is a measure word. You need to make sure that the noun fits the measure word 个. 那个人 is the correct way to say that person because 人 uses the measure word 个. What about 那个狗? Is that correct? No. 狗 uses the measure word 只, not 个. Now you understand a bit more about 那个 and won't just think Chinese people are being rude. You can even incorporate it as an authentic part of your own Chinese language. Next time you hear a native Chinese speaker say it, just remember they probably don't even know what the N-word is. What are some other Mandarin words that sound very similar to words in English or other languages? Comment below. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like and subscribe to see more content from Dig Mandarin. Thank you again for watching. 再见.